The next thing in collections we'll be studying about is hash sets, right? So hash set, link hash set, tree set are actually extending this set interface itself. It's actually implementing this set interface. So what we need to do is we'll be creating an object of hash set class. So I'll be creating class called as hash set example, right? Now we're going to see what is the difference in a set or a list or a hash set or array list. So I'll create an object of hash set, set equal to new hash set, right? So here as well, we will be using generics, as in it is showing a generic type E, that is like if I don't give any value, then the object that will be stored will be of an object class itself, right? So let's say I specify that I'm going to store string values over here. So I can say string, right? And same way, like we add values in a list, I'm gonna add it in a set. See, when I say set.add, it is actually showing an object of a string class itself. So I'm gonna add the value as in Raman. Then I'll copy paste and add some more values. I'll say a value as weight automation. Then I'm gonna add a value like Selenium, Appium. And let's say I add another value as Raman over here, right? So let's say I've added five values in a set. Now I want to print this set. So what I'm gonna do, I'll print the set. Now you're gonna feel the difference in a set and a list. If I run this, now the very first thing you're gonna see that the indexes over here are unordered, right? The list that displays over here is not in the sequence that we have provided over here. So set are unordered list, right? The second thing, that the value that we have given duplicate, the set only allows unique values. It will actually gonna override the previous duplicate value and we're gonna add the latest value. So this is a difference in a list and a set. If in case you are trying to store unique values, I mean, if in case you have a scenario, let's say if I talk about a practical example, we'll be working with Selenium with windows and tabs, right? The pop-ups. Now, what happened when, let's say, we are on a home page of an application? This is a home page. I'll, let's say, call it as window one, right? Which contains some ideas A, B, C, one, right? Then I click on any button, it opens up another window, right? Then there is a button on that window as well. I click on it and it opens up a third window. So there are three windows. This is window one, this is window two, and this is window three. Now at times when we need to switch, we need to perform some task on the second window, we need to switch our focus from first window to the second window. By default, all the operations will gonna happen on the first window. Now what Selenium it actually does is that it asks you for whenever you want to switch onto second window or third window or any other window that is opened by clicking on any button or a link, it asks you to provide the window ID for that particular window. It keeps on assigning a unique window ID. So if I talk about this window, there will be a unique window ID. If I talk about this window, there will be a unique window ID. This window, there will be a unique window ID. Now let's say while assigning the window ID, the first window ID is ABC1, the second window ID is ABC2, the third window ID, again by mistake it comes to ABC1. Now if we ask Selenium to switch onto the window which is having a ID as ABC1, so which window will it gonna switch? Will it gonna switch, let's say we are on the second window right now and we want to switch back to the third window or to the first window. We'll say Selenium, please switch to the window that is having a ID ABC1. So if I say ABC1, which window will it gonna switch? Will it gonna switch to the first window or will it gonna switch to the third window? So at times when handling these situation, Selenium developers, they want that they, whenever they are gathering the window IDs, the IDs should always come as unique, right? So what they'll do, they'll form up a set and they store all the window IDs inside this set, so that there will be no chance that the window ID, this set will gonna return us any duplicate window IDs. The window IDs that will be returned will always be unique. So this is like the a sample example on like why and where a set can be used, right? And this is actually practically implemented in Selenium as well, right? If you ever gonna work on Selenium, you're gonna see one of the method that is called as get window handles. What this method, the return type of this method, is basically a set itself, right? So that is what, when we are working on a hatch set, instead of this, I can write it like this as well. So this is like an interface, and then we can keep on adding values to a hash set like this. And if any duplicate value comes, the set will always gonna return you a unique value, right? Now this is what a difference in a list and a set. Now let's say if in case you want to get the value from the first index from a set, so how are you going to do it? So we're going to say set dot get. There is no get method inside set, right? Because get method, what it accepts is index. Now in case of set, the indexes are not ordered, so there is no purpose of using implementing a method called as get, right? So this is another difference in case of a list and a set. So you cannot fetch index wise values in a set. Now if I want to fetch all values from the set and I want to print it, then how are we going to do it? Shall we use a simple for loop? For int I equal to, now I will going to start from some index, and there is no index in case of a set, right? So if I say I equal to 0, let's say I less than set dot size and I plus plus. So what will you give over here when you are printing the index? So what value of I will you going to give over here? Where it will going to pass on the value inside set? There is no indexes in set. So we cannot use this simple for loop when working on a set. The second way is we can create a for each loop. So in for each, it will be iterated on this set itself, right? And we'll create a variable. And variable will be of a type that we have defined over here, that is of a string type, right? So this will gonna iterate over the set, and if we print the set, let's see if it prints it, and you can see it has actually printed all these four times. Okay, this is my mistake. We need to print this variable, right? So this is an individual variable which will be iterated over the set. So if I run this thing now, this will print the four values over here like this. So this is how we can get the values out of a set using the for each, right? Now the third way for achieving is the iterator that we have seen in case of a list as well. So we can create an iterator, ITR equal to, on this set, we're gonna putting up iterator like this, right? We'll import this, and now we're gonna say while ITR dot has next, and over here we're gonna print let's say dot next, right? So next, what it will gonna do, it will gonna iterate over the indexes. And you can see, okay, well, let me comment out this previous one, and if I run it again, so this is what it has actually printed. Now let's say if we want to print only the value of Appium, how are we going to do it? So we need to write something like if itr dot has next, itr dot next dot equals Appium, then what it should print? If I do it like this, what it will gonna print? Will it gonna print Appium? Let's see. So it has printed Raman, the next value, because iterate.next will gonna jump onto the next index of this set, right? It will not gonna print Appium. So each time you do iterate.next, it will move to the next index. Again, you do iterate.next, it will gonna move to the next index. So now what should we do? We can create something like a string var equal to, and we're gonna store this thing into the var over here, like this. Now it is throwing error because next returns you an object, because when we have set it up an iterator, we have specifically not defined the generics. That is, iterator will also be of a string type, as we have defined the set of a string type. So we will gonna do it like this, and instead of this, we're gonna say if var dot equals this, then print var. So this time when you run it, you're gonna see it will gonna print Appium. Right, so this way you will be doing it. And make sure to specify the generic type, right? While retrieving or while adding the values, you need to specify that what sort of values that you are actually using. So that is what we have in set. We're gonna practically see how this is implemented when we start working on these APIs like Selenium, right? So next thing after set, we're gonna look at maps, right? So in the next lecture, we're gonna see how the maps are going to work. All right.